everyone. Today we're going to be installing WordPress on our Arvix hosting account. The first thing we'll need to do is open the hosting account information email, which we've already done, and click on one of the links for the control panel. We'll log in. And now we're in the Arvix cPanel control panel. We'll scroll way down to the bottom to the section entitled Softaculous Apps Installer, and we'll click on the WordPress icon to begin the installation process. This is the Softaculous overview screen. We need the install screen, so we'll click on the button for that. This is the form we will need to submit in order to install WordPress. First section is the software setup. We'll need to select a protocol. We'll do that here. Second is a domain. The domain has already been filled in for us. Third is the directory, as we will be using WordPress as the content management system for the entire site. We would like to install WordPress in the root directory, so we're simply going to remove the WP and leave this field blank. Database name, the default is fine. Table prefix, the default is fine. Site settings, we're going to call our site NCM Test Site 02. Site description, we'll use NCM Test Site for Arvix. Enable multi-site, we only need one installation of WordPress on this domain, so we'll leave that unchecked. Next, we'll select a username and a password. Next, we'll enter an email address for the WordPress installation. Next, we'll need to select a language. English should do fine. Limit login attempts. This is an excellent plugin. It helps to thwart hackers, so we will have that installed and we'll click that box. We'll take a look at the advanced options here. Disable update notifications. We're going to leave that unchecked, as we would like to be notified when WordPress has been updated. Auto upgrade, we're going to leave that unchecked, as we would like to decide when to upgrade WordPress. Automated backups, always a good idea, so we'll back up our WordPress site once a week. Backup rotation, this is the number of backup copies kept on the server. For our purposes, 3 should suffice. We'll then enter our email address where we'd like the installation details sent. And finally, we'll click install. The message tells us that WordPress was installed successfully, so the next thing we'll do is log into the WordPress dashboard using the username and password we just entered into the form. Now we've arrived at the WordPress dashboard. And next, we'll take a look at our site by clicking the Visit Site link. And this is how our new WordPress site appears to visitors. As you can see, there's a default post here, Hello World. We can delete that using the WordPress dashboard. And to create a new post, simply click on the New Post and enter our title and our content here. I want to thank you for watching this video and remind you to visit NCM Online for web hosting reviews, coupon codes, and more.